Hey everybody, Reverend Riley here, back with another tech video. Today's video will be somewhat different, and it'll be somewhat like a podcast. And the topic that I'll be going over is how to live in the woods for about a week without technology. Everybody has a vacation of some sort, sometimes they don't have internet. Me, I went camping last week. I did not tweet at all. If you don't follow me on Twitter, you can follow me at Reverend Riley. And I usually tweet daily, and the days that I don't, I usually don't have internet access. So I have 10 different tips that could help you if you're going on a camping trip or a trip where you will not have internet. And so, my first tip is say where you are going and when you will be back on the social network. So, if you're on Facebook, leave a status saying, "Hey, I'm going here, I'm gonna be there this long, and I'll be back on this day." Same thing goes for Twitter. A tweet in this instant saying that I'm leaving for this amount of time, I'll be back this day, and I'll be tweeting when I get back. It's as simple as that. And then, if anybody's looking for you, all they have to do is look at your Facebook page or at your Twitter page, and they're like, "Oh, this guy, this person went here. I'll see them back after this date." And so that's what I did. I left a tweet with a video link to my vlog channel, and everybody was very supportive about it. And my second tip is turn all devices off before leaving. That way, while you're gone, notifications don't build up, making your device laggy when you get back, which is sadly what I did. I think I need to clear out my notification center, but it's something quite annoying because I came back to it. And so I think the next time this happens, I'll turn off my iPod. And it just makes it easier for on you for when you get back because you don't have all these notifications to attend to. Number three. Leave your devices at home sitting on your desk or wherever they are usually located. So, if it's your computer, leave it on your desk where it usually is. If it's your iPod, leave it sitting next to your computer or wherever you keep it. And if it's in your pocket all the time, keep it someplace noticeable, but not too noticeable, so you will be able to find it when you get back. And for me, usually I have my iPod in my right pocket. I'm right-handed, so it goes hand in hand. But when it's not in my pocket, it's on my desk next to my MacBook Pro. So when I left, I put it on the desk, and when I came back, same place. My next tip is forget about life online. You can think about what is person A doing right now. Me personally, I find that it builds up the intent to come back because if you're thinking about it all this time, you're more than likely not spending time what you're supposed to be doing. Like if you're going camping, you're not spending time with family, you're not spending time helping others like I was. Most of the time at camp last week, I was busy not thinking about the internet. I think I had a lot more fun out helping people, out spending time with friends than I usually do sitting on the computer all day. But then again, I like being productive, and since I've been back, I've been out having fun with my friends, and it really does make a difference to spend time with your friends compared to being on the computer all day. My next tip is go to bed at a reasonable time while you are on your vacation or while you're in the woods or camping. basically, if you want to have a good day, don't stay up all night because you're out. You're not home for a reason. You should go to bed at a reasonable time because you're probably going to be tired by the end of the day. And so that way you can get up at a good time. For me, it was about 6:30 to 7 o'clock. I spent all day doing my activities, going to different merit badges and other stuff. Different water activities, different land activities, biking, stuff like that. I had a lot of fun each day. Got back to my campsite, went to bed at a reasonable time, got up, and it just worked out real well. Doing that for about 7 days got annoying, and I think if I would have had a shower maybe every day, it would have been better. But other than that, it would have been real nice. I really do think having a good bedtime or time to lay down is something to have while living in the woods for a week. Number seven, enjoy the time with the people you are with. If you're out with family, stop thinking about the internet and help them out. Have fun, play games. If you're going swimming, have fun swimming. Talk about stuff. If you're there for a reason, have fun with whoever you're with. If you're with a Boy Scout troop, say, hey, let's play blackjack, let's play Egyptian rat screw. Just have fun with the people that are there. If there's nobody your age, walk up to somebody older and introduce yourself. Like, hey, my name is blah, and I like to do this. My next tip, take advantage of what you love while you're there. If you like music, take advantage of any radio while you're there, so you'd feel more at home. I know me personally, I listen to music a lot. And while I was at camp, I usually don't have a lot of music, but in one area of camp, they always had music playing, and I was there most of the day, so that helped me get through the week faster. If you like performing, perform for your group of people. And my ninth tip, take plenty of pictures. That way, you can go home and be like, hey, I had a great time. Here's a picture of us doing the A, B, and C. And then, if you want, you could make a slideshow after. And that way, you could post that somewhere, such as on your Facebook or even on YouTube, and be like, hey, I had a great time camping this week. Here's a bunch of pictures of me. Add some background music, a favorite song that was played. Just have a great time and capture it on film. And my 10th tip, plan to go next year, depending if you had fun or not, and if bad, how could you make it better? Basically, plan to go the next year. If you had bad times, what could have made it better? If you had a fun time and didn't have any negatives, think of other fun things that you could do. If you're out in the woods by water, what water sports could you do? If you're near mainly land, what land sports such as four-wheeling could you do? Water sports, boating, you could go kneeboarding, skiing, stuff like that. Really make the most of your time. Don't spend a lot of time doing one thing. And take advantage of the people that you know and the things that you are doing, because you may not have another chance to do those kinds of things with those people. And really, I had a great time at camp last week. Did I miss the internet? Yes. But was it going to be here when I got home? Yes. So I just looked forward to getting home after I had a great time at camp. So, if you felt like these tips helped you out, you can hit that like button. It really helps. You don't know how much, because I see a video that I just recently uploaded. It has 6 or 7 likes or more, and I'm like, yes, I helped a bunch of people out. If you want more technology videos, feel free to subscribe. If you want to follow me on Twitter, follow me on Twitter @RevanRiley. Follow me on Google Plus, RevanRiley. I hope to see you in the next video. Later, everybody.